We have started our street art scavenger hunt, and I'm going to go ahead and open Google Maps, and I'm going to search nearby. So let's find our location here. It kind of looks like we are having some problems finding it. There we go. Now, I want to kind of explore around the area where I am right now. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to go over here. And I'm going to drop the pin, and I'm going to go to Street View. So on the iPad, I would just click on this little image down here. So as I look around, I can kind of see I'm standing kind of in front of the school here. If the internet improves, that will be helpful. So right here, we're seeing this barricade that was meant to keep out flooding after Hurricane Sandy. That is not street art. That is actually just a banner that somebody printed out and put onto that abutment. So what I want to do is I actually want to go around and look for actual street art. We're probably seeing some people on their way to school here. Let's go ahead and I just want to sort of look around for examples of street art. So now I'm going past Manhattan Mini Storage on South Street. I can see evidence that there had been some street art right here, but it seems to have been erased or painted over. So I'm gonna keep looking. Nothing behind the sports facility, but definitely there used to be something here, right? If we look on this light post, you can see that there also used to be stickers there. So these are the kind of things that you can watch for. Street lamps are very popular places for sticker graffiti artists to put their stickers. Looks like somebody started a piece but didn't quite get to finish it. Here we go. We have a tag. On my iPad, I'm going to go ahead and capture the screen. Now I want to, that's going to get saved to my photos, and now I can continue to look around for more street art. Hopefully your device is working a lot better. And because I took the photo in Google Maps, the address is captured right there on the bottom of the screen, so I can kind of refer to that later. I see another tag here. It might help to even zoom in on it so I can get a really good look, and actually this would be a much better photo to use. I've got a couple tags already out of the five that I need, and I have addresses for them. And now I want to go ahead and go up this way, up Pike Street. Now we can really have a look around. Look at this. So these are some of the examples that we can see. This right here, this big red and white one, I would consider that as a piece. And the reason that's a piece and not a tag is because we have two colors involved. It's not just single line work. We're actually dealing with an area that was filled in. So I'm gonna go ahead and use that as my piece. And the reason it's not a wild style is because the emphasis is so much on kind of the graphic look of it. Now, as pieces go, that's a fairly simple one. I would actually say that something like this is actually more of a piece, just because they've engaged with kind of this look of the drips without actually making drips, but they've like painted fake drips onto the piece. This one right here is actually a mural, and the reason it's a mural, the reason you can tell it's a mural and not a piece, is that it has been signed in the lower right hand corner by the artist, which kind of signals that it has been legally sanctioned. This thing was on the up and up. This one on the side of the building here is definitely a mural. This is not something you would be able to pull off illegally. Now, there does remain the question of which part of it is mural and which part is piece. I would say that the flowery and bird shapes toward the top are part of the mural. And down here, we have a couple of pieces. Now, finding a wild style could be more difficult. So let's go across the street here and look into the skate park. Already we have a lot of tags kind of greeting us at the doorway. So that would constitute a lot of your tagging that you would see around. Okay. This here in the skate park would constitute a mural, but it would not constitute a piece. Actually, this alleyway here is great for street art, but let's go back for a second. Right here on this gate, right behind there, that is a wild style right there. I'm going to say, for the sake of your work and this demo, I don't want you to use any of the pieces that I'm using as an example, just because that would be a little bit too easy and I'm just handing it to you. So then what you're going to do is you're going to go ahead and open Google Slides, and you're going to create a new slideshow, and you're going to say new presentation, and you're going to call it Street Art Scavenger Hunt. There we go. And you are going to load in your pieces, and you can give it a nice title, like, you know, Street Art Scavenger Hunt by Mr. Z. And then we're going to go ahead and add a slide, new slide. There we go. And all we need is kind of a main point, right? So here we're going to add a picture. Hit the plus, there it is, image from photos. Allow it to add the photos. And we are going to go and grab our tag right here. We're going to say, let's pull this over so it's, actually we want like an image and a caption. So that's a tag, and that's at 199 Cherry Street. Tag, 199 Cherry Street, Manhattan. And you're going to add another slide, and you're going to say, okay, there's a good caption one. So then you're going to add an image. This is gonna, and you don't have to do one per slide. You can do several of them. So like, let's add two more tags. We get any more? I'm gonna call this one a tag just because. So this is, I'm gonna say tags, and then you would just add their locations. So 199 Cherry Street and 68 Monroe. And those are both in Manhattan. All right, so then once you're done with that, you're gonna save your scavenger hunt. You would keep going, and then you're going to go to Google Classroom, and you're just going to upload your scavenger hunt to the assignment, and that's going to constitute a lot of points for you. The scavenger hunt is worth, I believe, 120 points. You're going to get 10 points for each piece that you find, so it's going to be fun, and you have over a week and a half, I think, to do it. So you should have plenty of time. You can do it in Google Street View, or you can do it walking around, and I recommend walking around if you are able and are safe doing so. So that's it, pretty much. Best of luck. Can't wait to see what kind of street art you come up with.